Before we end the discuss for this morning, in case you're just tuning in, you are listening to Maloney FM 95.9, the Cradle of Enlightenment. My name is Habila Yusuf, and we are looking at some of the pressing national issues. We have a text message here saying, good morning, Mr. Presenter. The President Tinubu said that removal of fuel subsidy will give life to our economy. I ask, where is the money that is gotten from the fuel subsidy removal? CRAP should sue the president to court to explain to us what the money is being used for. I mean, this text is not far from what I was trying to explain. Nigerians said, okay, you have removed fuel subsidy. You have stopped paying subsidy for fuel. Now you told us that you are making trillions of naira from the removal of fuel subsidy. And Nigerians are going through so much hardship. Nigerians expected, or in a sane country, what is expected of you, of this administration, is to ensure that they set the ball rolling by providing cushioning effect of this fuel subsidy removal. Money is being made. You are sending monies to governors and other people to give to the people. And then you have some of these governors who are greedy, like our politicians' way of doing things. Money comes to you, you claim the president said we should hold our governors responsible for what we are going through in this country. And I said, you know these governors, or you know these leaders. Why did you have to give them money to say they should send, give us this money, or find a way to reach out to us? Why don't you put this money, for instance, if you remove subsidy from fuel, why don't you pay subsidy on transportation? Why don't you pay subsidy on agriculture? Why don't you pay subsidy on other things that would directly have a positive impact on the common man? Why do you have to send money to the governors? Why do you have to buy bags of rice and share it into little portions and call Nigerians to line up and take 3 or 4 mudu to take home that will not last them for the next 2 weeks? Is that the way to cushion the effect of the fuel subsidy? And we're saying some Nigerians believe that it is a scam, because in the end, what we're making out of the removal of fuel subsidy is not coming back to Nigerians. But the president and the administration of Bola Ahmed Tinubu will keep asking Nigerians to make sacrifice and even make more sacrifice. The question is, what sacrifice has the members of the House of Representatives made for this subsidy removal? What is the sacrifice the senators are making? What is the sacrifice the governors, the House of Assembly members are making, that you're asking a common man who is finding it difficult to eat 2 meal per day, or even 1 in a day, to make sacrifice? From where is he going to, or she going to make that sacrifice? Where is that thing that you are asking Nigerians to use and make the sacrifice? These are some of the issues. And Nigerians are saying, look, we had callers who have sounded like they have given up on this country, where a caller will say, we know that our leaders are using our money for their personal businesses. They turn our commonwealth into their personal wealth. They are using our money to finance their children abroad. They are using our money to build mansions abroad. They are using our money to sink into a business outside the country. They are using it for whatever reasons that is personal to them. But what the leader should do for us, according to some Nigerians, is to simply bring back the payment of the subsidy and open up the borders. These are some of the issues that we have this morning. It's just a minute before 9 o'clock. I think we would end it here. We want to appreciate every one of you. This is the Discuss on Maloney FM. Tomorrow is Friday. My colleague, AB Dollar, will be here. to kick up the weekend with you with the weekend status. And of course, information never runs dry on this platform. At 11 o'clock, Rahina Tugaya-Garaku will be here with the Hausa program, Batumwayo. And of course, it's also a current affairs program where we can allow our Hausa listeners express themselves concerning the state of the nation. Don't go anywhere. Keep listening to Maloney FM. Appreciation to every one of you who took time to call in and make your contribution, and you who decided to patiently listen to us. We wish you all the best, and of course, you should keep listening to Maloney FM. We are now closing now. Good morning. My name is Habila Yusuf.